tennis ball. You don't have to have one. That's the only thing we might use. And we'll be focusing on the spleen meridian today. The spleen meridian runs up here on the front and outer edge of the ribs, comes down through the abdomen, connects with the spleen, and then it also runs up the inner seam of the thigh. This is a very long meridian in the body. And we'll start off by maybe offering a little bit of length here toward the inner seam of the leg by visiting Baddha Konasana if it's comfy. Now we'll be tuning into our breath while we're here. So if you can't hold Baddha Konasana and focus on anything like your breath, it's fine to take a more comfy seated place. Or another option to still be in the shape, but that might add more comfort, is to have the feet together and the back resting on the mat. Supta Baddha Konasana, or the reclined version of back angle. So I'll let you choose what feels best for you. Both work. What we'll be doing here is just letting the knees settle toward the mat as we notice our breath. You might even rest your hands on the belly. And if it's comfortable, we might try three breaths where we breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth. That can help release any stuck tension. So we'll take a deep breath in toward the belly, in through the nose. And sigh out through the mouth. Deep breath in through the nose. Sigh out through the mouth. One more like that. In through the nose. Out through the mouth. And then let your breath return to normal. And just take a moment to notice how things are feeling today. And again, it's okay to shift out of Baddha Konasana if it doesn't feel good, if it feels too early for this shape, it's okay to shift out of it. Or you might check in and notice if there is tension here along the inner edge of the leg. You might notice how the shoulders are doing today. You might notice your breath. As your breath finds its natural pattern again, do you feel the belly expand a little when you inhale? And then when you're ready, we'll use an exhale to bring the knees toward each other. Your hands can even help. And your choice, if you're seated, we're headed toward a side bend. So we'll be reaching up and over. Or if you're on the mat, you'll take the arms up over the head and find your left wrist. And when you exhale, take the arms up and over toward the right, making a C shape with the spine. Can you breathe when you're here? This is the more gentle way. If you want to add a little extra into it, you can stretch the legs out long, send them over to the right as well. Maybe even crossing left leg over the right. Banana asana. Can you breathe when you're here? Opening up that outer edge of the ribs. And perfectly fine to be flowing here if you're seated practicing this. When we find an inhale, we'll all make our way back to center. Whether that's seated or on the mat, you might take a moment to give the knees a little rock. And then we'll prepare for side two on the exhale. Take that right wrist up and over to the left. And we might just stay like this, just focusing on this outer edge of the rib cage. And try to keep the shoulder and hip down, and we might add the legs, sending them to the left. Maybe right leg even crosses over the left. Does this side feel different than side one? Can you still breathe towards your belly? And then when we find an inhale, no rush, no hurry, we'll make our way back to center, bending the knees, maybe giving them a little rock, side to side, taking a breath. And no rush, no hurry, but if you're on your back, we'll make our way up to seated, either by tucking the knees in and rolling and rocking. That can be really comfy on the back, depending on how things feel today. Or we can roll to the side and press our way up to where you're seated. Meeting and seated, just taking one more breath in Baddha Konasana. Noticing how the feet join, noticing if the knees can soften and settle down. And then we'll take and bring the legs out long. Finding Dandasana legs. Now if you have a hard time sitting up tall, if you feel like you round back and your legs are long, just add a bend in the knees for today. So either here with bent knees or here in Dandasana. We'll take an inhale, sweep the fingertips up tall. Exhale, find a gentle twist toward one side. And as we find the twist, I'd like you to imagine whichever arm is behind you, can you think of opening this side of your ribs? So even though we're twisting and taking it back, once you get in the twist, you might think of shining those ribs out to the side. Can you breathe when you're there? As you release, we'll inhale it back to center. We'll go to the same side again. Drawing the spine up tall, lift through the crown. Exhale, open into the twist. And same idea, we might try to shine this outer edge of the rib cage, expanding, maybe even thinking of the breath, rolling down that side of the lungs, down toward the belly. When you inhale, take it forward. See if anything needs a little shrug or settle. Once more to this side, we exhale into the twist. And then we think of shining those side ribs. And spine stays tall. And chin stays parallel to the mat. Sometimes when we twist, we take the head up and back. We want to keep the chin parallel, just like we were balancing something on the top of the head. Inhale it back to center. Give the shoulders a little roll. And you might bend the knees if the legs were straight, just to give your back a moment to release too. Again, for a lot of us sitting with long legs, this isn't always comfy. Take a breath here before we switch sides. You don't have to turn, but I will, so it's easier to see. When you're ready, we'll either send the legs long or we'll twist from our bent knees. Both ways work. Deep breath in toward the belly. Spine lifts tall. As you exhale, find that gentle twist toward the side. Now this side could feel really different. On this side, can you think of expanding and shining those side ribs? Like we're filling that part of the rib cage. And then when you inhale, bring it back to center. Draw the spine tall. As you exhale, we twist. Same side once again. If you feel a lot of opening in the shoulder, that's something we can breathe into as well. Again, the top of the spleen meridian runs right here. And then as we inhale, we'll find our way to center. Once more, nice tall spine. Exhale, find that seated twist. And shining or expanding the side and the front of the ribcage. Spine stays tall with this twist. And as we inhale, we find our way to center. And then we'll release the back, your choice. You might just fold forward. You might bend the knees and over the knees. Or you might reach back and rock the knees. Just finding what feels best for you today. Some days if we come to practice from a really busy morning with a lot going on, We might find he's drawing in calming shapes better. Or if we've had a nice leisurely morning, we might find lifting the collarbones up and rocking is a little more energizing. And then when you're ready, we'll find our way back to seated. This time it can be a comfy seat. And your choice, we can take cat-cow seated if that feels best. Or we might make our way toward all fours. Or even elbows under the shoulders if the wrists aren't comfortable. Use the exhale to lift and round. The inhale to gently arch. Thinking back to the engagements we talked about last week, we might bring them in here too. Think of lifting the bottom of your torso, your pelvic floor, drawing the bottom of the torso in and up. Think of drawing the front hip points toward each other. And then think about those low ribs, knitting them in toward each other as well. Let's go one more each way. And as you exhale, settle hips back toward the heels. Take a moment in child pose. Maybe rocking the forehead a little on the mat. And then as you inhale, your choice can stay put here and settle if it's been a busy morning and you're ready just to rest. Or we can find a gentle flow here of owning our puppy stretch, hips high, arms long. Inhale, shift toward cobra or baby cobra. Exhale to puppy. Inhale toward cobra. When you shift back, notice in the hands, where do you press through? Do you press through the whole palm evenly? One more. And then when you're ready, we'll meet down on the belly of the back. Taking a moment when you arrive to maybe bend the knees and give the legs a little rock side to side. And then if it's comfy, we'll draw a little attention to the hips here too. So letting one leg reach back long. Bend the other knee about 90 degrees. Add a little flex to your foot. And just see, keeping the knee at 90, just see what it's like to tip it one way and the other. And then if it's comfy when you tip it across the other leg, take a pause there and settle. And then you can play with this further. If it feels really tight just to be here, stay put. Inviting the foot to settle. Or you can play and just explore, reaching the other leg on top to help the foot settle down. And if it doesn't feel good, again, if things feel too tight, it's okay to skip this. Just an option, not a requirement. Taking a breath. And then maybe lifting that left leg up if it did come down over the right. Bending the right knee to take both knees bent. Even both a little rock side to side. And then we might try that on side two, knowing that the hips can be really different from one side to the other. Sending the right leg long. Now left knee bends for the side you didn't do before. And just find the range of motion here. If you keep that knee bent at 90, does this one tip out to the side more? Does it tip across more? Sometimes it's like one leg just falls right down and the other leg is stuck. And then crossing that left leg over the right, trying to keep the knee about 90 degrees. We can stay here and rest, or we might play now with taking the right leg up and over, helping that left leg sink down. And if you find that just cranks and lifts your left hip up, it's okay to skip it. It's okay to play with adjusting. You want to try to wrap the left hip down toward the mat. Breathing when you're here. And then gently releasing the right leg by bending the knee, bending on the left. Give both a little rock side to side. So the spleen meridian does run through the hip, but tension here in these hip rotator muscles can add and affect the ways that we can open and lengthen the inner seam of the leg. So that's part of why we're giving them a little attention. And then your choice, you could stay here and rock if that feels good, or now we'll start to draw some length toward the ribs and the side ribs. Tucking the elbows in underneath, making our way toward Sphinx pose. And in our Sphinx, we want to think about taking the sternum, the center of the ribs here in the front, and drawing it forward. And sending our sacrum here at the base of the spine backward. So can you think of dragging the sternum forward while you reach the sacrum back? And we can stay put just like this, or if it feels comfy and in your range of motion, you might try walking the elbows over a little bit to the left to help lengthen that right side of the ribs. Try to keep the shoulder wrapping back from your ear. And then we'll inhale our way back to center. We'll take a moment, draw the sternum away from the sacrum. And when you exhale, maybe we walk the elbows over to the right. We'll watch that left shoulder. It might sneak forward. Try to roll it back from the ear. And taking a breath, and then walking it back to center. One more breath in Sphinx, sternum away from sacrum. Exhale, release down to the belly, and you choose. Bend the knees and rock to release and soften. Or we can create a little bit of length by finding our stargazer pose. And there are different versions of stargazer, but the one we'll practice today is the left ear on the hands, looking at your right elbow. Inhale, lift the right elbow and maybe the left leg. Exhale, them down, turning the head. Inhale, lift left elbow, right leg. Exhale, down, turning the head. Inhale to lift. Exhale to lower. So it's hard to see sometimes on the video, but this is elbow and opposite leg. One more each way. Inhale up. Exhale down. And then take a moment to soften. You're welcome to wiggle the hips or rock the heels. And then no rush, no hurry, but when you're ready, we might try taking that right knee and sliding it up toward the right shoulder. This is half of frog pose. We can stay put here just resting. Or if it's comfy, we might play with extending that right leg out. And can we think of letting the right hip sink toward the mat? Breathing while you're here. And then gently bending the knee, sliding the right leg back. See if heels need a rock or hips need a wiggle. And we'll move toward side two. Left knee draws toward left shoulder, half frog pose. Pausing here to settle. And this is one that helps address spleen meridian on the inner seam of the leg, but also gives the hip a chance to slack in and release. We can stay put here, or we can press out through that left foot. I'm trying to let the left hip settle down to the mat. When you're ready, no rush, no hurry, releasing the left foot, lengthen it back. One last opportunity to rock or to rest. And then with legs back long, we'll take fingertips by the ribs. Inhale, curl up to baby cobra or maybe a cobra pose. Exhale, shift down left hips to heels. Soften and rest in child pose if that feels best. Or this is yogi's choice. There's time for a gentle flow like cat-cow if that feels good for your back. Or three vinyasa flows. Our down dog, to plank, knees touch chin, and cobra or an up dog. Yogi's choice. And take your time to rest or flow. Notice your breath. Notice if it seems to support you, to move with you, and to flow. Or if there are parts you hold your breath, sometimes in a flow, the more challenging bits, we pause and hold the breath. So I'd invite you to keep that flowing. And then when you're ready, we'll start to make our way back to meet on all fours. No rush, no hurry to get here. And I'm gonna turn so it's a little easier to see me for this piece. When you find all fours, take a moment, take a little shift side to side. We can also work here from the elbows if we need. And then stand out, lifting the pelvic floor, engaging the abdominals, hugging the ribs toward each other. And see if it's possible to take that left knee up and out without taking your whole back. So your back tries to stay flat as we lift that left knee up and out. We can exhale it down and inhale it up. And take your time, you can flow here, or if you wanna hold it, try pressing the leg out long. You can turn this into awkward sun dog if you like, by seeing if you can float the right arm. And when you're ready, gently bring it down. Take a moment to shift a little side to side. Give the hips a little shift side to side. And then we'll move over to word side two. So finding if the knee can float without taking the whole back open. And we might pulse here, exhaling down, inhaling to float. Exhaling down, inhale to float. Or we might press the leg long. We might just stay here. Or I might play with the awkward sun dog, seeing if the left arm can float. Breathe in if you can. And then when you're ready, gently bring it to all fours. And take a moment to shift the hips a little side to side. So, sometimes that's called fire hydrant. And that really lets us explore how to lengthen here. The muscles in the back of the hip have to engage. So now we'll give those hips a little more attention. Go ahead and press the left heel back. And then tuck that left knee down outside the right leg. Your hips might get enough stretch here. Or to add more, we'll settle the hips back. We may just stay here, or we might let the hips come all the way down between the heels. For today, you might just stay forward, breathing in toward the hips, inviting gentle length there. And if you'd like to add a little more for the swing, you can walk the hands up and over to the right. Then come back to center. We'll lift back toward all fours. Float the left knee. And then before we go to side two, we're gonna bring that left foot between the palms. Take an inhale, sweep it tall for our kneeling lunge. Exhale, hands to the heart. Find to stay put here. Or maybe we find a little open twist, opening toward the right, if it feels comfy. And you could explore here, just letting that left knee press out a little bit, hoping to open the inner seam of the leg. And if it's comfy, you might just give a little attention here to the inner edge, inner and back on that left knee. Just giving it a little squeeze or drawing a circle there. It's one of the points on the spleen meridian. And then when you're ready, no rush, no hurry. We'll find our way back towards center. Use an inhale to sweep it tall. Exhale, hinge and fold, frame the foot. Slide or step back to all fours or high plank. One breath here. Exhale, downward facing dog. Pedal in, bend one knee and the other. And then when you're ready, we'll settle knees back to the mat to meet on all fours. Preparing for side two, finding neutral, engaging pelvic floor, drawing the ribs toward each other, and then pressing that right heel up and back. Bend the knee, send it down outside the left leg. Heels can move apart from each other. And this might be enough stretch for the hips. Or we might start to slide the hips back. Might pause and stay here. Or you can let them settle down between the heels. Being kind to your knees. Listening to your hips. More is not always better. If you feel a lot of sensation, sometimes backing off to a place where you feel a little sensation and you can breathe is more helpful. And then you might walk your hands up and over to the left. Helping to lengthen that right side body. And when we're ready, gently bringing it back towards center. Use an inhale, bring it toward all fours. Float the right heel up and back. Exhale, knee toward nose, flip between palms. Take an inhale to lift. Exhale, hands toward heart. Kneeling lunge. Now we might just stay put right here. Or if you can keep the spine tall and it feels comfy, we'll find a gentle twist. Now opening the shoulders toward the left. And I'll turn. It's easier to see. And you might stay put here, you might take a hand to that front leg. And maybe just draw a few circles with the thumb to the inner edge and the back edge of the knee. That's one of the swing points. And that's a spot they say it's best to give it attention when the knee is bent or flexed. And it can help stimulate the flow of lymph fluid there when you do that. And then gently bringing it to center when you're ready. Use an inhale, sweep it up tall. Exhale, hinge from the hips to frame the foot. Sliding back to all fours or stepping back for a high plank. A deep breath here. Exhale, shift and lift, downward facing dog. Pedal in, bend one knee and the other. And then when you're ready, no rush, no hurry. It's yogi's choice. You can bring it down to take a rest. You can take your three vinyasa flows. Or if there's something else that needs attention, you might take your time and go there. No rush, no hurry with it. Noticing your breath and how your breath works with you to support you here. And then as you find your way toward the end of that last flow, we'll make our way back toward a seated place, in any comfortable seat. So they say when you're stressed, that activates the triple warmer meridian. And that one pulls some of the energy from the spleen meridian, which is why when we're stressed, especially long-term, we tend to have weaker immune systems and get sick when we're exposed to that chronic stress. So this next piece is a little funny, but this is thought to help calm the triple warmer meridian. Donna Eden calls this the triple warmer smoothie. And you can start, just a fun thing to do, you can start by resting the fingertips on the forehead if it's comfy. If you don't want to touch your face, you'll just hover the hands over. That's okay too, and works just as well for the meridians. But you can slide the hands apart from each other toward the temples. Take an inhale here. Exhale, slide them back behind the ears, down the neck to hang on the upper traps here between the neck and the shoulder. Deep breath in here. Exhale, slide them down toward the heart. And again, you can hover the hands over the heart if it doesn't feel good to rest them on the heart. That's okay too. And then we'll do that two more times if it's comfy. Again, you don't actually have to touch. You can hover the hands over if that feels better. It works just as well. So taking fingertips toward the forehead, use an inhale to separate them, coming over toward the temple. Inhale here. Exhale, slide them down and back behind the ears, down the neck. Take an inhale here, hanging on the trapezius. Exhale, settle hands toward the heart. And pausing here for a breath. And then let's take one more, just like that, if it's comfy. Hands toward the center of the forehead. Use the inhale to draw the fingertips to the temples. Inhale here. Exhale, take the fingertips behind the ears, down the neck, hanging on the shoulders. Take an inhale here. Exhale, sliding hands down toward the heart. Notice your breath. Did it slow? Did it calm? Did it shift in a different way? Just noticing. And then when you're ready, no rush, no hurry, from there we'll bring it back toward all fours. And then explore cat and cow now, using the exhale to round, the inhale to arch. And just noticing if anything feels different there. And then when you find the next exhale, settle the hips back toward the heels, finding your child's pose. And you can rock the forehead on the mat if it feels good. And then we'll take a little side stretch variation here, walking the hands over to the right. If it's comfy, stack that left hand on the right, taking a breath here. And then leave the right hand in place. But see if you could open that left arm toward the right hip. Taking a breath here. And we'll bring that left hand back. Inhale it toward center. Exhale, take them up and over to the left. Maybe resting right hand on the left if that's comfy. And then maybe the right hand can open back, reaching toward the left hip. And that's helping to open that top part of the meridian here. Releasing back, inhale toward center, taking another breath here. And then the next inhale presses us up to where we're seated. Hips to the side. Bring the legs around forward and check back in with your Baddha Konasana here. Just noticing if it feels any different. And then we'll explore if it's an option for you, keeping that left foot in place, I'll be your mirror. Send that right leg out long. And just notice where you feel tension in this shape. Or if you feel tension in this shape, is it the inner seam of the leg? Is it in the back and the hip? Just notice if all of your muscles relaxed at the same time, what shape would you move to? For me, that would be a folding forward and this leg would come back in. And just notice for you how things feel in that shape. And then if it's comfy, we'll take a little walk around here. Using the hands for support, let's walk away from the right leg. Maybe taking a little twist toward the left if that's comfy. And then we'll walk it back over toward that right leg. And then we'll open the left arm back, lifting the collarbones up. Maybe we look up to, or maybe we keep the chin parallel to the mat. And then we might walk that right hand toward the right foot. The left arm could reach up and over if it feels good. We're taking the hand behind the back and help draw some space here. Or if the hand reaches up today, I'd encourage you to stretch and squeeze through the palm, giving your lymphatic system a little boost. You have a lot of places for lymph to drain here in the underarm, around the collarbone. Then inhale, sweep it all up to center. Exhale, hinge and fold over that left foot. Breathing here. And taking your time. That's yogi's choice. If it feels good just to be here, if you can feel some space coming in the inner thigh, you can just stay put here. Or this is a spot you might use your tennis ball. The big toe is where the spleen meridian starts, the inner edge of the big toe, and it slides up the leg from here. And then it goes up toward the hip and comes up this outer edge of the ribs. So it's up to you. You are welcome to see if you can find a little help in the stretch with the tennis ball. Just drawing some circles up the inner seam of the leg. Being kind. It felt really good to work behind the knee. Bend the knee to work that spot here. That's what helps. That's what the most is a little flexion in the knee. So it's up to you. You might be working with the leg here. Or if the hip pieces are really helpful, we can transition into pigeon from this shape. Classic pigeon, you would open this left foot out a little more. Use your hands to help support as you tuck that right leg under to find your pigeon. So this is an option to bring more focus on that right hip. Or if you're thinking you want some pigeon, but you don't want to go there, there's a seated pigeon variation where we would take the ankle to the thigh and fold. So yogi's choice here. Stay with focusing on the inner leg, maybe working with the tennis ball, or if that's too intense, maybe even just drawing a few circles there with your hand. And you can also, let me say this is a flush for the spleen meridian. You can trace the meridian backward. So coming from the inner edge of the ribs, we slide down the outer edge of the ribs, by the hip, down the inner seam of the leg toward the big toe. So you trace it backwards and then you trace it the right way three times, coming back up the inner seam of the leg, up the side body. And you don't actually have to touch. You can also hover the hand over without actually making contact. That works too. Maybe tracing one more time if you are tracing the meridian. And don't worry, we'll do this on side two as well. And then just taking a pause to notice how things feel. Might assess in this shape, or if it's more comfy, Come back to Baddha Konasana and see how that feels. And then if the hips, or the shoulders, the back need anything, take a moment to give them a rock or a little motion. And then we'll find our way over to worm side two. We'll have the right foot staying in front now as that left leg reaches out long. And it's okay if it doesn't feel comfy to be here. It's okay to bend this knee to work in a different shape too. Or if we can sit tall, just notice where you feel the tension on this side. Might be the same as side one or maybe not. Maybe this side is the inner side of the leg. Maybe this side is your back. If it's comfy, we'll take a little walk over, a little twist, opening the shoulders toward the right. Keeping the spine tall as we do. And then we might take a little walk over toward that left leg. We might open the right hand back and inhale the collarbones up. Maybe we look up two, or maybe we just keep the chin parallel to the mat. And then we might walk that left hand over toward the left foot. We might reach the right arm up and over. Or we might tuck it in behind, helping to open the front of the shoulder there. If we're reaching up and over and it feels comfy, we might take it up and stretch and squeeze through the hand, again supporting the lymphatic system here. The lymph and the spleen both help support our immune system. And then we might float the hand down, inhaling our way towards center. Exhale, if it's comfy, you might hinge from the hip and fold over that right foot. And it's fine just to stay put here, especially if you can feel like there's tension here, but it's starting to let go. You can use your tennis ball to work again from the inner edge of the big toe, up the inner seam of the leg. And if you find there's a spot there that could really use attention, you might be working there. It's also okay to work other places with the tennis ball, like back, if that's what needs your attention today, or maybe it's a calf, work where you need to. And then if you'd like to they call it flushing the meridian, it's helping to get rid of any stuck, stagnant energy. We can do that too on this side, coming from that, like the inner edge of the shoulder where the upper ribs are. We trace down the outer edge of the ribs, down the inner seam of the thigh, and off the big toe. So that's tracing it in reverse, and then we trace it up three times, either touching or hovering the fingertips up the inner seam of the leg, coming up the outer edge of the ribs, and then taking that direction two more times if it's comfy, if this seems helpful. And you might notice sometimes the tension that was in the leg, it might shift, it might dissipate. Just noticing that. And taking a breath when you're here. Noticing what's different. Maybe assessing that in this shape. If all of a sudden it's comfy now. Or maybe bringing the feet together and just seeing in Baddha Konasana what feels different, or what is sending you signals and attention. If Baddha Konasana is comfy, you can stay here or find a comfy rock or a comfy movement for the back. Taking what's needed there. And then we might take just a moment to tap a few times on a couple spleen points. So this just helps get good energy going there again. So we can find our low ribs here in the front, then tap if that feels comfy. If they feel sore, you can also give them a little rub or even just Just hold gently, putting a little pressure there. Or you can also draw attention in here too to the side ribs. That's an option as well. Taking a breath when you're here. And then no rush, no hurry. When you're ready, give the hands a little shake. And then yogi's choice here. We have a couple different options. Movement might feel really good now. It might feel good to take a few seated up and overs. Or things might feel ready to just rest and soften and soak in some of that new space and better energy flow. So please feel free to stay up and bring movement in if that feels good. Reclined table might feel good there too if you're staying up. Or if you're making your way down to the mat, we'll find our way to the back, taking a little gentle rock side to side. And then your choice. If the side body work is helpful, revisit that banana asana, sending arms and legs to one side. Or I'd encourage you to come back to the hip, give the back of the hip a little more attention too, with reclined pigeon. Taking an ankle to the top of the thigh, and then we might float it up here. We might press it up tall. Breathing when you're here. So again, the spleen meridian doesn't run through the back of the hip, but the way that these muscles being happy and healthy influence the muscles on the inner thigh, that part does have some bearing. Not to mention the nervous system. If we can release some tension here, that can often help calm the nervous system too. No rush, no hurry. If this side just started to feel good, you're welcome to stay put. Or we might send that foot back toward the mat. And before we go to side two, we might hug that knee in close. Maybe draw a couple circles with it. And maybe even take that knee out to the side body, just taking another moment to draw a little length toward the inner seam of the leg. And then when you're ready, that foot can come down and we'll switch sides. Resting ankle to top of thigh. Maybe this side stays here. Maybe we draw the knee up. Finding a little rock if that's comfy. Breathing when you're here. You're welcome to lengthen the other leg up if it feels good. Maybe just noticing the difference from one side to the other. And then when you're ready, we can make our way toward floating that foot to the mat. So we'll hug the other knee in close if it feels okay. Drawing a little circle here. And maybe opening the knee out to the side if that feels comfy. And just inviting a little more length through the inner seam of the leg. And then yogi's choice. We might settle the bottoms of the feet together for Baddha Konasana. Just resting here if it feels good. Or we might give our lymph system another boost, maybe by pressing the feet and the hands up, and then giving the hands and feet a little flex and point, or a little scrunch and squeeze. Your lymph system is a lot like your circulatory system, except instead of having a heart to pump and move the lymph, it's depending on the different movements you do with your body. And then when you're ready, making our way toward restorative, you're welcome to choose any restorative pose you like. If you're thinking legs up the wall would feel great today, it's a nice pose to help support the spleen meridian too with that inversion for the legs, or separating the legs, that's great too. Or you're welcome to take constructive rest. Knees bent, feet on the mat. In the classic shape, you'd cross the arms over each other here. And this is a nice spot to pause and rest if it feels comfy. When you exhale, you might think of just letting the body sink down toward the mat. And if you'd like, again, you might take our reclined butterfly here, taking the feet together and the knees apart. Or constructive rest, the way it helps to release the psoas muscle here, that can help support relieving congestion in the front of the hips. And no rush, no hurry. If it feels great, you can stay put for Shavasana. Or at any point over the next few minutes, you might send the legs long and turn the palms up for a classic final relaxation. But it's always okay to be where you're comfy here. Either bending the knees or resting the hands on the belly, all those are good too if they feel more comfortable for you. And then we'll take these last few minutes of practice just to let everything we did today soak into the body. If you're able to take a long Shavasana today, feel free to do so, just resting and softening here. You might bring motion back to the fingers and the toes, finding what's ready to stretch and reach out. Start to bend and draw in close. And take your time finding what would like to move. And then we might make our way over to rest on one side or the other. Pausing here as long as you need. Use an inhale to help draw you back up to center when you're ready. Take a moment, maybe you visit Baddha Konasana just to see how it's feeling at this moment. And then finding a comfy seat, take a moment to see if the spine needs a shift side to side, if the shoulders need a roll or shrug, or if the neck needs any length. When you find an inhale, sweep the fingertips up tall. Exhale, settle hands toward the heart. Thank you all for taking the time to practice today. It's such a pleasure to practice with you. And namaste.